Hello everyone, in this video I will be discussing about design of compression members. Starting with the first problem here, design an angle strut using a single angle section to carry a design load of 225 kN, so it's a factored load, and is asking us to use M20 bolts of grade 5.6. The length of the member is 2.5 meters. So angle strut, in the sense, it's a compression member and it's part of a truss. We have to design an angle strut, and the type of section to be used is given, an angle section, and also is saying that you have to use only one angle section, and you have to design this to transfer a load of 225 kN without failure. And the dia of bolt is given M20, and the grade is also mentioned, 5.6. The length of the member is also given, that is 2.5 meters. So similar to design of tension members, or if you consider any design, you have to choose the section first. The type of section is mentioned that you have to use a one angle section, but you have to choose the particular type of section, whether it may be an equal or unequal angle. It is better if you go for unequal angle always, and longer lead is preferably used for connection. Now, in order to choose a section, we need to find out the area required for the load to be transferred. So the load to be transferred here is 225 kN. So in order to choose a particular angle section, we need to find out the area required to transfer that amount of load. So for that, we will be proceeding with this first step here, finding out the area of the section. You are aware of this formula here. It is a formula for design compressive strength. PD stands for design compressive strength. It is given by AE into FCD. So this formula is available in the code book. AE is nothing but the gross area of the section, and FCD is the design compressive stress. Now, rearranging this formula, you'll get the formula for area required in this fashion. AE is equals to PD by FCD. So in place of PD, you have to substitute the load acting over here, that is 225 kN, and FCD, design compressive strength. While determining the strength of compression member, we used to get this FCD from table 9. Whereas here, while finding out area, we will be just assuming the value of FCD. You can assume any value between 50 to 250 is left to you. As the value of FCD increases, the area required decreases. So it is better if you choose or assume the value of FCD less, so that you will be getting the area required more. Because this area required and FCD are inversely proportional. So substituting these values, so I will be assuming FCD as 100 now. The design compressive strength for which you have to design is 225, so same value you have to be substituted in the place of PD. So the required area will be getting around 2250 mm². So as our area provided in the steel tables are in centimeter square, if you convert it into centimeter square, it will be 22.5 cm². If you remember, while designing tension member, you used to increase this area by around 20 to 30%. You can try this here also, or else you can proceed as it is. It is left to you. So for this design, I will be proceeding as it is without increasing the area required. So for this particular area, you have to choose one angle section. I told you that it is left to you. You can go for either equal or unequal, but if you go for unequal, it is better. So using this area now, I will be choosing a section from steel table. So I will be opening a steel table now. Either you can use any steel table which you have purchased, or you can use IS SP 6 part 1 1964 handbook. So both are one and the same. You can see here, this is the properties of rolled steel unequal angles. You can see first a designation is provided here, the type of angle. So its size are mentioned here, 90 and 60 are the size of angle legs. Next followed by thickness, sectional area of this particular section, and its weight per meter, its center of gravities, distance from extreme fiber, moments of inertias. These properties are continued in the next page also, with the radii of gyration. You're having four values for this particular section: RXX, RYY, RUU and RBV. You can refer the sections here. This is XX, YY, UU and VV. And you're also having modulus of sections ZXX and ZYY, and having tan alpha also. And you are having a root radius. This is called as you can, if you observe here, it is having some radius over here. It is called as a root radius, and this is called as toe radius. And you are having product of inertia, and once again designation will be there at the end. So designation of the section will be at the starting as well as at the end. So our required area is 22.5 centimeter square. So go on referring this cross-sectional areas. You can go with 125, 95 and 12, whose area is 24.98 centimeter square. You can go with this also. You can go with even this also, this or this. So the value is 22 point something, the area required. You can provide any section whose area is more than the required value. But you have to choose a section such a way that its cross-sectional area should not be less than the required area. So we'll proceeding with ISA 150, 115 and 10. So these are the four thicknesses. The leg dimensions are same, but it differs with the thicknesses here. So we're going with 150, 115, 10. So its area is 25.52. Units will be mentioned here at the top. So it's in centimeter square. So required is 22 point something. And you are providing a section whose area is 25.52. So you can proceed with this section whose area is more than the required area. So we'll be trying with the section ISA 150, 115 and 10 mm. So the provided area will be 25.52 centimeter square or 2552 mm square. So this is the first step. You're finding out the area required. Based on the area required and the type of section to be used, you'll be choosing a particular section and you'll be knowing the provided area. So next step is you have to check for its safety. Once again, you have to use PD is equals to AE into FCD. So you'll be using this formula to perform the check. So in place of AE, you can substitute, you have to substitute the provided area, that means the area of the chosen section, and FCD. So this FCD now, in the first step, you assume the value of FCD. Whereas here, you have to get this FCD from table 9. In order to get this FCD, you need slenderness ratio. So you can get the value of FCD from table 9 if you are aware of slenderness ratio. So first you have to calculate slenderness ratio. For that, effective length is required. So you will be calculating effective length also. So as soon as the first step, that is the area of the section and choosing the section, you are going for the next step, that is finding out the effective length. So you have three conditions here. You have solved it while determining the strength of compression members. If it is an angle stretch, having three conditions for effective length. Only one bolt is used for connection, effective length will be equal to the length of member itself. And if you are using more than one bolt for the connection of this compression member, then effective length is given by 0.85 times of L. And if you are going for welded connection, then the effective length is given by 0.7 times of L. So here, assuming that we will be providing more than one bolt, obviously we will be providing more than one bolt. So the effective length of an angle strut, when you are using more than one bolt, it will be equal to 0.85 times of L. So 0.85 times of the length of member is mentioned in this question, it is 2.5. So the effective length will be equal to 2125 mm. So next, we will be calculating slenderness ratio now. So slenderness ratio is given by lambda, that is LE by R minimum. So L is nothing but effective length, we have calculated it earlier. So R minimum, what is this R minimum? R is nothing but the radius of gyration of the particular chosen section. So you will be having, I showed you in the steel table that you will be having four set of values, RXX, RYY, RUU and RVV. So among those four values, the minimum value are to substitute in place of R minimum. So let us go to the section in steel tables. So this is the properties of unequal angle, single angle section. So radius of gyration will be provided in the second page. You can see the radius of gyration here. So once again, designation will be provided at the end. So the chosen section is 150, 115 and 10. 10 is the second line. So we have to refer these four values. The least among these four values, you have to substitute in place of R minimum. So out of these four values, 2.44 is the least value. And the unit of this is centimeter. So 2.44 centimeter is the least radius of gyration value. So in mm it will be 24.4. So effective length is also substituted in mm. So lambda will be 87.09. So the last step is finding out the safety of this, that is check, which is given by once again design compressive strength PD, that is area into FCD. So in place of AE, you have to substitute the provided area, that means the area of the section chosen. The area of the section chosen is 2552 mm square, and now this FCD you have to get it from table 9. So if you refer IS 800-2007, you are having 4 tables for table 9. So out of that, you have to decide which table 9 you have to use. In order to decide that, you have to take the help of table number 10. So in table number 10, the first column is given the various different kinds of cross sections. So we are using an angle section. So it falls under buckling class C. That means you have to refer table 9C. Let us give one more other example. So if you are using this hollow circular or square or rectangular section, then if it is a cold formed, then it falls under buckling class C. So in such case, you have to refer table 9B for getting the value of FCD. Whereas here in this case, we are using angle section. So it falls under buckling class C. You can see here, this is a buckling class. So there are 4 classes of buckling. So if you are using angle section, it falls under buckling class C. So you have to refer table 9C to get the value of FCD. If you see this table here, so this KL by R is nothing but the lambda slenderness ratio. So these are slenderness ratio values and these are yield stress values. So in this table you are having design compressive strength FCD values, and the unit of these values are in MPa, that is Newton per mm square. So these are all the FCD values for different slenderness ratios and different yield stress values. So for us, yield stress is fixed, that is 250. That means you have to refer, you have to get the values of FCD from the values which are in this particular column, provided for the particular slenderness ratio. The slenderness ratio we have obtained here is 87.09. So for the lambda or slenderness ratio of 87.09, and for yield stress Fy of 250, the value of FCD will be, so it falls under these two values, 80 and 90. That means it falls under 121 and 136. So if you interpolate, the value will be 125.36. So this is how we get the value of FCD from table 9. And based on the type of section you are using, you have to choose the 4 tables. You have to choose a particular table from those 4 tables. So in this case, we are getting FCD as 125.36. So the design compressive strength will be 319.92 kilonewtons. What is the meaning of this value here? So this particular section which you have provided, that is a single angle section, 150, 150 and 10 mm, can transfer a maximum compressive load of 319.92 kilonewtons. Whereas the load acting is only 225. So its capacity is this much, the load that is being transferred is 225. So the design is safe. So this is how you design any member, whether it be angle strut, a column or anything. This will be the steps. First you have to get the area required for the section. Based on the area, you'll be choosing the particular section. Then in order to perform check, you need to get effective length and slenderness ratio, that you'll be calculating. And then the last step will be the check. If the connection is asked, you have to go for connections. So in this problem, the connection is asked. He is saying that you have to use M20 bolts of grade 5.6. So let us proceed with connection now, as he is asking to perform the connection. Now, the type of section you are using here is an angle section. This angle section will be connected to a gusset plate. So if you refer this figure, assume that this is a compression member, a single angle section. So if it is an unequal angle, longer leg will be used for connection. And this compression member, the angle strut, should be connected to something, and this is called as gusset plate. So if you are going for connection here, You have to find out the number of bolts required for this particular connection. That is what you are going to do now. So if you are going for connection here, it involves two thicknesses. One is thickness of gusset plate, and the thickness of one angle length. So dealing with two thicknesses, so it is nothing but a lap joint. So NN will be 1 and NS will be 0. So NN and NS are justified now. So what about the value of T? See, thickness of gusset plate is not mentioned, so any details pertaining to gusset plate is not given. So you can assume the thickness of the gusset plate. So I'll assume that the thickness of gusset plate is 15 mm. The thickness of angle leg is 10 mm as per our design. So out of 15 and 10, 10 is the least value. So the value of T will be 10 mm in this case. So NN is 1, NS is 0, and thickness, the least thickness is 10 mm. The diameter of bolts to be used is given 20 mm. The diameter of bolt hole, including this clearance, it will be equal to 22 mm. So pitch and edge you can calculate using these formulas here. So we'll be getting 50 and 35. The calculate shear capacity will be 56.6. And if you're calculating bearing capacity, it will be 83.31 kN. But of these two, this is the least value. So that will be the bolt value or design strength of this particular connection. Next, you have to calculate the number of bolts required, which is given by load by bolt value. The load acting here is design value is 225 divided by bolt value is 56.6. Both are in kilonewtons. You're getting 3.97 volts. So you have to provide 4 bolts for this particular connection. So this is a gusset plate, this is an angle section which is being used as a compression member, and there are 4 bolts to be provided with a pitch of 50 and edge distance of 35. So this is a cross sectional view. So here he has assumed the thickness of gusset plate as 10. So if we compare these two values, the least is 10 itself, so he has taken T as 10 mm. So this is how you design and perform the connection. So moving on to the next problem. Design an angle strut using double angles to carry a design load of 600 kN. If the length of the member is 2 meters, use M20 bolts of grade 5.6. So previous problem you designed an angle strut with only one single angle section, whereas here he is asking you to design with two angle sections. So this is also an angle strut, there is a part of a truss. The length of the member is 2 meters and the load which is acting here is also a factor load of 600 kN, and you have to perform the connection here also with the M20 bolts of grade 5.6. So once again you have to get the area of the section. So using this formula, PD is equal to A into FCD, rearranging it, you'll be getting it as AE will be PD by FCD. So in place of PD, you'll be substituting this load here. So this is in kilonewton, this must be substituted in newtons, as FCD which you are going to assume will be in newton per mm square. So once again FCD you have to assume here. So assuming it as 150, so the required area will be 4000 mm square or 40 centimeter square. So this 40 centimeter square which you obtained is the area combined for two angle sections combined. So 40 centimeter is the area required for two angles combined. So now you have to refer the steel table wherein you are having the properties of an angle section which are placed back to back, provided I told you that you have to go for unequal sections. So you have to refer the properties of unequal angle section which are placed back to back with longer legs placed back to back. I told you that longer legs will be used for making the connection, so you have to refer the properties of double angle sections, preferably unequal angle section, whose longer legs are placed back to back. So those properties you have to refer and choose the particular section. So here I am using this properties of two angles back to back, unequal angles with longer legs back to back. So this is our connection will be. So these two are unequal angles and longer legs are placed back to back. So we need this type of section whose area will be equal to, or should be equal to 40 or more than 40 centimeter square. So here sectional areas are given here. So if you go on referring this, I can go with this particular section. The required is 40 centimeter square. So here it is 42.04. So I can go with ISA 125, 95, 10. So 125, 95 the dimensions of the legs of the angle, and 10 should be the thickness. So you have to refer all the values which are in this third line. So cross section area required was 40. So this cross sectional area is the area of two angles combined. So required was 40, provided is 42.04. So I'll be going with ISA 125, 95, 10 mm angle. So going with 2 ISA 125, 95, 10 mm. So the provided area will be 42.04 centimeter square or 4204 mm square. Next you have to calculate the effective length. Once again, this is an angle strut. Obviously we'll be using more than one bolt. So the formula to get effective length will be 0.85 times of L. The length of member is mentioned. So based on that, the effective length will be 1900 mm. So 1.9 meters. So calculating slenderness ratio. Once again, it is LE by R minimum. So LE I have obtained here. So this R minimum, you have to get it from the same table. So for this particular table, for this particular section, you are having this first value in the first page, the radius of direction RXX. So for 125, 95, 10, you have to refer the values in the same line. So RXX will be 3.94. So if you go to the next page, RYY. So for this particular type of section, we'll be having only two radius of direction, RXX and RYY. So RX you have obtained already, but RYY you have to obtain from among these values over here. So these are all our RYY values. Based on the distance between back to back of angles, you have to choose the RYY. So these are all the distance between back to back of angles. So 0.0, that means there is no gap between the angles. 0.6, that means there is 6 mm gap between the two angle sections. So this is 1, that means 10 mm, 14 mm, 18 and 22 mm. So based on the gap we are providing between our two angles, we will be getting the value of RYY. So once again, in this question, no details pertaining to gusset plate is given. So I'll be assuming that the gusset plate we are going to use will be of 10 mm thick. So once again, going back to this table over here, we assume the thickness of gusset plate as 10 mm. So the gap between the two angles will be 10 mm. That means, so all these values are given in centimeters. So if it is 10 mm, the gap will be of 1 cm. So the RYY should be taken below this value 1. So for 125, 95, 10. So 125, 95, 10 is in the third line. So RXX we have obtained as 3.94 cm. So RYY below 1 you have to refer. So 125, 95 the third line. So it is 4.01. So out of these two values, RXX 3.94, so RXX directly will be getting, RYY you are having different set of values. Based on the gap between the two angles, you will be getting the value of RYY. So in this case, you are assuming that the gusset plate in between two angles is of 10 mm. That means there is a gap of 1 cm. So in order to get RYY, you have to get the values which are below 1 cm. So out of these two values, the minimum value is 3.94 cm. So it will be 39.4 mm. So slenderness ratio will be 43.15. So going to the next step, check, which is given by PD is equals to AE into FCD. AE you have to substitute the provided area, that is the area of the two angle section chosen, that is 42.04 cm square. This is nothing but 4204 mm square. So now this FCD you have to obtain it from table 9. So once again, referring table 10, we'll come to the conclusion that this angle section which I am using falls under buckling class C. So once again, you have to refer table 9C from code book IS 800-2007. So from table 9C, so Fy is always 250 fixed for a lambda of 43.15. so lambda falls between 40 and 50 for 250. So it will be between 183 and 198. Based on the required value of lambda, interpolating it, we are getting the value of FCD as 183.275. So this value is obtained from table 9C for the lambda or slenderness ratio of 43.15 and for the yield stress of 250 Newton per mm square. So if you substitute this, the design compressive strength will be 812.53 kN. That means if you are going with an angle strut where you are using two angle section, then its compressive strength, that means the maximum compressive load it can take without failure, is 812.53 kN. But the load exactly acting over here is design load of 600 kN. The strength is 812, but the load acting is 600, so our design is safe. So if the number of dia of the bolt and grade is given, you have to go for connection. So try the connection for this particular arrangement over here. Use 20 dia bolts of grade 5.6 and calculate the number of bolts required over here. So I'll just give you a hint how to calculate NN, NS and the value of T. You see the cross section over here, you're dealing with three thicknesses here. So this will be the cross section here. Two angles, two longer legs are placed back to back, in between you are having a gusset plate. So dealing with three thicknesses here, that means it is similar to butt joint. So both NN and NS will be assuming it as 1. That means number of shear plane in the red region will be 1 and the number of shear planes in the shank portion will be 1. So NN 1, NS 1. So how to design T now? So while you are designing the double cover butt joint, you used to summate or add the thicknesses of cover plates. So these two are nothing but the cover plates now. You have to summate the thickness of these two and you have to compare it with the thickness of gusset plate. The least among the summation of these two and the thickness of gusset plate will be the value of T. So no problem, the angle which you are using is 125, 95 and 10. So thickness of angle X are 10. So 10 and 10 is 20 and 10 is on one side. So 20 and 10, comparing these two values, 10 is least. So T will be 10 mm. So NN1, NS1 and the thickness, the least thickness will be 10 mm based on the assumption which you used to go with the double cover butt joint. So this is design of angle strut, both single angle as well as double angle sections. So moving on to the design of columns now. So design a column section using single load steel beam along with cover plates. So this is an compound section or built up section, you can say. So what is this compound or built up section? So if a ready made section, along with the ready made section, if you are using another ready made section, that means if you are using an I section with the channel section, it becomes a compound section or built up member. So in this case, he is saying that you have to design a column. So as of now, you are not dealing with the struts. You have finished the design of struts now. You are dealing with the design of column one. So you have to design a column section with an I section as well as cover plates. So cover plates are nothing but an ordinary plates which will run throughout the length of the column or any member along with the flanges. So if you are going for I section, you will be having two cover plates, one for each flange. So here using both I section as well as plates, so it becomes a built up member or a compound section. And he is saying you to design for a factored load of 2000 kN. Here end condition is given. So he is saying that both the ends of the column are fixed and the length of the member is 6 meters. The reason why he is mentioning the end conditions here is that, so if you are designing the struts, it depends on the one bolt, more than one bolt and welding connection. The effective length depends on those three factors. If you are designing a column, the formula for effective length, you have to choose it from table 11. And you get this value for effective length from table 11 based on the end conditions of the column. End conditions are the sense whether the two ends are fixed or two ends are hinged, or whether one end is fixed, the other end is hinged. So based on that conditions, you will be having different formulas for effective lengths and we can get it from table 11 of codebook. So in this case he is saying that both the ends of the column are fixed and the length of the member is 6 meters. So once again the procedure will be same. Whenever you are going for design, you have to first get the area first based on the load conditions, and based on the area and the type of section to be used, you will be choosing the section from steel table. So starting with the first step, area of section is given by PD is equal to AE into FCD. So rearranging it once again, so this will be the formula to get the area required. So in place of PD, I have to substitute the load which is to be designed, that is 2000 kN. And FCD, once again I told you, you have to assume here in the first step. So FCD is assuming it as 180. So the area required will be this much now. As a factor of safety, we will be increasing this value by 30%. So if you increase it by 30%, this will be the new required area in mm square, and this will be in centimeter square. So now the type of section to be used, he has mentioned, and it should be of an I section with two cover plates. So now we have to refer the properties of an I section with two cover plates. So here it is, you have to refer this table. So this table gives you the properties of an I section along with two cover plates. So these two cover plates, the length will be equal to the length of the I section itself. So as long as the column or any beam runs along with it, the length of the cover plates also will be the same. So you can see here, so this particular, it is a composed of a joist, is nothing but an I section along with the cover plates. So this gives you the designation of the I section, and these two gives you the dimensions of the cover plate, the width as well as thickness. So I calculated the area now. The area required is 144.4 centimeter square. So to go on referring the cross sectional areas here, you have to choose a section whose area will be more than the required value. So we'll be going with this particular value here. So required is 144.4. So this is having a cross sectional area of 147.55 centimeter square. So we'll be going with an I section ISMB 250 and a cover plate of width 200 mm and thickness 25. Because the area matching over is this line, so thickness also should be selected along the same line. So I'm going with ISMB 250 I section and a cover plate of dimension, that is width 200 and thickness 25. So this is a section I'll be going with. So the provided area will be 147.55 centimeter square. So next step, we have to calculate the effective length. So here we are designing a column. I told you that you have to get the formula for effective length from table 11. So let us go to table 11 from IS 800-2007. So this is table 11. So various end conditions are given over here. So this is one end and this is one more end. So for each end, the description is given for the translation motion, that is along the motion along x and y axis, and this is rotational motion. For both the cases, or both the ends, the translation motion as well as rotation is mentioned over here. If you see the first case here, at one end the translation motion is also restrained, rotation is also restrained, that means one end is fixed. At the other end, translation is also free, rotation is also free, that means the other end is free. So this is the case, one end is fixed, the other end is free. So each end is defined by translatory motion as well as rotational motion. So our case, he says that both the ends are fixed, that means both the ends, translation as well as rotation, should be restrained. So this matches our description. Translation as well as rotation at one end is restrained, that means it is fixed. Once again, translation as well as rotation motion is fixed on the other end also. So both the ends are fixed, and this column gives you the formula to calculate the effective length. So based on our end condition, that is both the ends are fixed, the effective length formula to be used is 0.65 times of L. So 0.65 times of L, the length of the member is given, that is 6 meter. So our effective length will be 3.9 meters. Once again, to calculate centerness ratio, this is the same formula. Lambda is given by LE by R minimum. So LE I have obtained 3.9, that is substitute here in mm, so 3900 mm. Once again, now R minimum you have to obtain it from steel table. From the same table we have got the area and you have chosen the particular section. So if you see here, so directly least radius of gyration is given here. So for our particular section, that is ISMB 250, 225, so this will be the least radius of gyration, 4.99. If you are getting confused with the unit of this, you can refer it here. So it is in centimeter. So our value is 4.99. So in mm, it will be 49.9. So this will be the least radius of gyration which is obtained from steel table. So perform the last step check. PD is equals to AE into FCD. So AE is the area of this I section as well as cover plates combined. So this is obtained from steel table and FCD. Now this FCD should be calculated from table 9. So out of 4 tables, in order to choose which table to be referred, once again go to table number 10. So you have to cross check now it falls under which category. So this is for rolled I section, this is an individual I section, this is for welded section, this is hollow sections, and this is the welded box sections. And these are channels, angles, T-section, solid blocks, rectangle, square or circle. The last case is built-up member. That means if you are using more than one ready-made section. So here we are using both I-section as well as cover plate. So I told you that this falls under compound member or built-up member. The section which you are going to use comes under built-up member, so it falls under buckling class C. That means you have to get the value of FCD from table 9C once again. So for the obtained value of lambda and for the yield stress of 250, you will be getting FCD from this table. So the lambda which I calculated here is 78.16. So it falls between these two values. That means under 250, it is between 136 and 152. If you interpolate it for the required value, the FCD will be 138.94. So substituting these two, we'll be getting design compressive strength as 2050.2 kN. So the strength of this particular I section with cover plates is this much. The load acting is 2000. So we're getting a difference around 50.2 kN. So it is safe. The strength is 2050. The load acting is 2000. So it is safe. Moving on to the next problem. Design a compression member using double channel section which are placed back to back to carry a factor load of 1600 kN. The length of the column is 5 meter with one end fixed, the other end is hinged. So here you have to use two channel section which are placed facing back to back. And the load to be handled by this column is 1600 kN, it is a factored load. The length of this particular column is 5 meter and the end condition is one end is fixed. That means both translational as well as rotation are restrained and the other end is hinged. So if it is a hinged connection, a hinged support, rotation will be free but the translation motion will be restrained. So based on this end condition, you will be getting effective length formula from table number 11. So starting with the first step, getting the area of the section. So you have to go with the two channel sections facing back to back. So rearranging it, you will be getting this formula over here. The factor load acting here is 1600. So FCD you have to assume here, you will be assuming it as 180. So the required value will be this much. After increasing it 30%, this will be the new value, 115.55 cm². So remember that this is the value. This is the area required for both the channel sections combined. Now if you go through the steel table, you won't find any properties for this kind of arrangement of the channel section. That means two channel sections facing back to back. So if no properties are available directly for compound sections, then you have to refer the single channel section properties. So the previous case, two angles which are faced back to back, properties were already present in the steel table, So directly took the values from them. Whereas here there are no properties of channel section facing face to face or either back to back. So in such cases, what you have to do, you have to refer the properties of only single channel section. So this is the area combined for two section. So as we are referring for only single channel section, this area has to be divided by 2. So the area of each channel section will be 57.78 centimeter square. So now we have to refer the properties of single channel section from steel table. So these are the properties of single channel section, and the area we are looking for is 57.78 centimeter square. So these are the cross sectional areas. So to go on looking for the area which is more than or equal to the required value of 57.78. So if you refer all this value 57, you can go with this section also. 58.25 you are getting. So you can go with ISLC 400 also. So we are going with ISMC 400, whose area is 62.93. So required is 57.78 for one angle, for one channel section. So I am going with ISMC 400, 49.4 kg per meter. So this is a kg per meter, whose cross sectional area will be 62.93 centimeter square. So as we are instructed to use two such channels, so using two ISMC 400 at 49.4 kg per meter, so the area will be 62.93 centimeter square for one channel section. So we are using two channel sections, so total area will be 125.86. So now the total area required was 115.55. We are providing with 125.86. So next, going on with effective length. Once again, you have to refer table 11 for this. The condition given here is one end is fixed, the other end is hinged. So referring table 11 from steel table, sorry, code book. So one end is fixed, that means both the translation as well as rotation motion is restrained. And if the other end is hinged, so translation motion is restrained, but the rotation is free. So to look out for that particular condition. Going through this, so this will be our condition. One end, both translation as well as rotation is restrained. On the other end, translation motion is restrained, the other end is, sorry, the rotation is free. That means this is a condition for hinge. So this is condition for fixed. So one end is fixed, the other end is hinged. So this will be our condition. So this will be our formula for getting the effective length. That is 0.8 times of L. So effective length is 0.8 times of L from table 11. So length of member is given 5 meters. So effective length will be 4 meters now. So now next step is getting this slenderness ratio, which is given by lambda is equals to LE by R minimum. So LE we have obtained it as 4 meters, whereas R minimum we cannot get it from steel table now. The reason why we cannot get it, the radius of gyration is, there is no properties in the steel table for two channel sections combined which are facing either face to face or back to back. So in such cases, you have to calculate the radius of gyration using this formula over here. That is root over I minimum by area gives you R minimum. So let me explain this figure now. So this is how we are designing the column section, two channel section facing back to back. At a distance of, let's say, D. This D have to calculate now. So what are this X and Y? So this particular point is the centroid of two channel sections combined. And this X-axis is the centroidal X-axis, and this is the centroidal Y-axis for both the sections combined. Or else you can say this is a global X-axis and global Y-axis, which are for two sections combined. Remember that this is a centroid and these two are centroidal axis. So coming to this individual section, this will be the centroid of this individual section. So if you are not sure of the location of centroid of this particular section, you can refer steel table. In the steel table, if you refer the figure at the top, you will be getting the location of centroid. So always for these kind of sections, the centroid will be outside the section. So this is where the section centroids is for channel section. So this will be the centroidal X and Y axis for individual section. So coming back to this figure, so this will be the centroid of this individual section. So this will be the centroidal x-axis and centroidal y-axis, and I will call it as this is local x-x and local y-y axis. So here you can see this distance from this particular point till here will be given as c by y from scale table. You can get it this way, you can get this value from scale table under the heading c by y. From this edge to the location of centroid, you will be getting this as c by y. It is equal to 2.42 centimeter in this case. The same thing, this will be the centroid and this will be the local xx and local yy axis. So now we have to get the moment of inertia of the both channel sections combined with respect to xx axis and yy axis. So using parallel axis theorem, so moment of inertia with respect to global xx axis will be equal to moment of inertia with respect to local xx axis plus a into h square. So this is the moment of inertia of single channel section, and this is the area of single channel section, and h is the distance between the local xx and global xx axis. It's nothing but the distance between two parallel axes. So this is the parallel axis theorem which you have studied earlier the previous semesters. So this value, that is the moment of inertia of this one channel section with respect to its centroidal axis, you can get it from steel table. You can see here from this steel table you can get both Ixx as well as Iyy. You can see here moments of inertia Ixx as well as Iyy you can obtain from steel table. For this particular channel section, this will be the Ixx value and this will be the Iyy value. So those are the values which are written here. So in this place you can substitute the value which you have obtained from steel table plus. So here you have to substitute the area of one channel section. Once again you can get this value from steel table and a cross sectional area. So remember all these values I am substituting in centimeter square now. You can substitute with mm square also. So if you are starting the values with centimeter, make sure that all the values in centimeters or all the values are in mm. It is left to you. So I am going with centimeter values now. So area of one channel section 62.93. And h is the distance between two local axes. In this case, the local x-axis and global x-axis. You can see here both axes are coinciding. That means h will be 0. So there are two such channel sections. So simply multiply it by 2. So Ixx will be getting 30165.6 centimeter to the power of 4. So you got Ixx. Now you have to calculate Iyy. The least of these two you have to substitute in this in order to get r minimum. Moving on to Iyy, moment of inertia with respect to global yy axis is given by moment of inertia with respect to local yy axis, or nothing but moment of inertia of one channel section. This value can be obtained from steel table plus a, area of single channel section, and h is the distance between the local yy and global yy axis. If you refer this figure, we need to substitute this distance from this particular point, local yy axis, to the global yy axis. So from here to here I can say it as d by 2. So distance from this particular point till here I have taken it as d. So from here to here it will be obviously half. So d by 2 is from here to here, and from this particular point till here it is c by y. Told you I can get this value from scale table. So this 2.42 plus d by 2 will give you the distance between the local yy and global yy axis. So that he has substituted here. 2.42 is a c by y plus d by 2 whole square. There are two such channel sections, so into 2. So in this equation you can observe that there is an unknown here. In order to avoid or overcome this unknown, we will be equating Ixx and Iyy. So Ixx value we are aware now, 30165.6, and Iyy is this equation. So if you equate these two, so in this equation the only unknown is d, you will get the value of d. D is nothing but the distance between these two channel sections. So obtain the value d. So we are in the process of finding out I minimum, but you have gone with this condition Ixx is equal to Iyy. So the I minimum will be the same, that is Ixx or Iyy. So Ixx is how much now? It is 30165.6. So that I will be substituting here. In place of area now you have to substitute the area of two channel sections combined. So that will give you r minimum now 15.48 centimeter. So previous problem used to get this value directly from steel table. So if the properties are available in the steel table, you can get the directly the value of r or r minimum. the properties of this compound section is not available in the steel table, you have to calculate R minimum using this root over I minimum by area. So now we have obtained with R minimum, go ahead with lambda. L you have calculated earlier, it is 4 meters and R minimum is 15.48 centimeter. So 4000 by 154.8 mm, so both are in mm now, so lambda will be 25.83. So the last step is check, it's given a PD is equal to A into FCD. So in place of A, you have to substitute the area of two channel sections combined, the provided area. So now FCD, so once again this falls under buckling class C, it's a built up member, so it falls under buckling class C. Once again you have to refer table 9C. So from table 9C, for lambda of 25.83 and for Fy of 250 Newton per mm square, FCD will be 216.421. So this is obtained from table 9C by using this value as well as yield stress of 250. So design composition we are getting is 2723.74 kN. That means if I am designing a channel section with ISMC 400 placing back to back with some particular distance of D, it can take a maximum compressive load of 2723.74 kN. The load acting is just 1600 kN, so our design is safe. So neither this problem or previous problem is asked for connection, so no need to go with connections. If at all is asking you to connect and is giving the diode bolts, you have to use an extra place to connect these two channel sections. So that we will be handling while designing the lacings. So as of now, he has asked you to only design without any connections. So this is where we have to stop. So move on to the next problem. So design a compression member using double channel section which are placed face to face to carry a factored load of 1600 kN. The length of the member is 5 meter with one end fixed, the other end is hinged. See, all the load, the end condition and the type of sections to be used is same. The only difference is the previous problem, the channel sections were facing back to back, whereas here they are facing face to face. Once again, this will be the centroid of two channel sections combined, and these two will be the centroids of individual section. So local centroidal axis, this is a local centroidal axis, and this will be the global centroidal x and global centroidal y axis. And this distance from this particular point till here will be chosen as d and will be calculated later. So starting with the area of the section, so whereas previous problem we assumed FCD as 180, whereas here it will be going with the 200. So required area will be 8000 mm square. So increasing by 30%, it will be 104 with followed by 2 ohms mm square. So for one section, once again the properties of two channel section is not readily available. So you have to divide the obtained area by the number of section used. So number of section used here is 2. So half of the total area required will be 52 centimeter square. So now you have to refer the properties in steel table for single channel section and choose the particular section whose area should be more than 52 centimeter square. So I'm going with ISMC 350 at 42.1 kg per meter. If you're going with the two section, he has asked you to design with two sections. So total provided area will be 107.32. So required was 104 centimeter square. Provided is 107.32. So you can proceed with this section. So once again, finding out effective length. So one end is fixed, the other end is hinged. So based on table 11, so effective length is given by 0.8 times of L. So 0.8 times of length of number 5 is 4 meters. Once again, slenderness ratio. Here LE is known, R minimum should be calculated using this formula, as radius of gyration for two channel sections combined is not readily available. You have to calculate manually R minimum. So once again, you have to calculate IXX and IYY using parallel axis theorem. So IXX, this value can be obtained from steel table, and this is the area of one channel section. Once again, if you refer this figure, local X and global X are coinciding, so the distance between two parallel axes is zero. The two such sections, so into two, so IXX will be this much. Once again, IYY, so this value once again from a steel table for one channel section plus area, this is also from a steel table. So now H is the distance between local YY and global YY axis. So this distance from this particular point till here you have to calculate now. If you refer this figure here, I told in the previous round that the distance of location of centroid, that is this particular point from this edge, will be given as CY line. So width of flange also will be mentioned in this tail table. So width of flange minus CYY will give you this distance, that is 75.6 mm or 7.56 cm. So distance between global and local Y axis will be equal to this distance. From here to here it will be d/2 plus 7.56 cm. That is what it is being substituted here, whole square. There are two such channel sections, so into 2. So in this equation d is unknown, once again we will be equating Ixx and Iyy. From that we will be getting d as 11.6, the moment of inertia as 20016. So if you substitute here, we will be getting r minimum as 13.66 cm. So lambda will be 29.28. So performing the check, so once again here, so you have to be careful here in this formula. So here area should be substituted, the area which is the area of two channel sections combined. Not, you should not substitute the area of one channel section here. You have to be careful in this step. So once again, after getting the lambda, AE is once again the area of two channel sections combined. So once again, this falls under buckling class C from reference table 10. So if it is buckling class C, you have to get FCD from table 9C. So for lambda of 29.28 and for yield stress of 250 MPa, we'll be getting FCD around 211.94 of tender plating. So design compressive strength for this particular section will be 2274.5, so which is obviously more than the load acting, so our design is safe. Moving on to the last problem in design. Design a compression member using four angle section, which are to be arranged in the shape of a box of size 400 by 400 mm. So you have to use four angle section, you have to arrange in such a way that it forms a box of size 400 by 400, it's a square. And this column has to carry a working load of 2500 kN. That means this is an unfactored load. You have to factor it by multiplying it by 1.5. The height of column is given, which is required for calculating effective length. And also end conditions are required to calculate effective length. So the end condition is one end is fixed, the other end is hinged. So on one side, both rotational as well as translation motion is restrained or fixed. And the other case is, and the other end is hinged, that means translation motion is restrained or fixed and the rotation is free. So this is how you have to arrange four angles within the limit of 400 by 400. So once again, starting or going with the area of the section, rearranging it, we'll be assuming FCD as 200, we'll be getting AE as 185.5 centimeters square. So once again, there are no properties in the steel table for four angles combined in whichever fashion. So what you have to do is, you have to divide this total area obtained divided by the number of sections to be used. So the number of sections to be used here is 4. So the total area divided by 4 for one angle section area will be 46.87 centimeter square. So now we have to refer steel table for single angle section, and whose area matches or equal to or more than this value, particular value. So here the angle should be arranged in the form of a square box. That means both the sides, the dimensions are same. So if you go with equal angles, it is very good here. If you go for equal angles, the number of steps involved in the further design will be shortened. So my suggestion, whenever there is a problem of this kind, go for equal angles. So as of now, go for equal angles. I'll tell you why it is advantageous in the further steps. So go for equal angle, choose an equal angle section with the area equal to or more than this value. So we're going with ISA 150, 150, 18, four such ISAs. So each area is 50.79. So for one angle, the area required was 46.87. So I have chosen a section whose cross-sectional area is 50.79. So four such angles, the total area provided will be 203.16. The required area was 187.15. The provided is 203.16. You can proceed with finding out effective length. Once again, from table 11, one end is fixed, the other end is hinged. The formula of effective length will be 0.8 times of L. So it is 0.8 times of length of member is 5, so effective length will be 4 meters. Now, if you refer this figure or even this figure also, this will be the centroid of all the four angle section combined. So this will be the centroid of x and y axis are nothing but global x and global y axis. The centroid of each angle section will be over here. So this will be the local x and y axis or centroid of x and y axis for single channel, sorry, angle section. So reason why it is advantageous here is the gap between these two will be same throughout. The angle chosen is 150-158. So you can easily calculate the gap between these two now. So total distance is 400. So this is 150 and this is 150. So 300 if you remove, you will be left with 100. So the gap will be 100 here. And the advantage is for going for equal angles is both IXX and IYY will be same, because even the overall cross section is also symmetrical, and if you deal with these two angle section is also, it is also symmetrical. So both IXX and IYY are same. If you would have chosen unequal angle, these distances would have also been different, and also you are supposed to calculate IXX as well as IYY separately, because that values will vary. So always dealing with this kind of problem, go with equal angle. So here I axis is given by x is plus 800 square. So this is for local one angle section. You can get it from steel table. So this is also area of one angle section. And h is the distance between local x and global y axis. Sorry, xx axis. So this distance, you can easily get it. This distance from this particular point till here, you can refer the other figure which is over here. So this distance will be given in your steel table. So this we are aware, 150, and this will be equal to d by 2, that is 50 in this case. So 50 plus 10.62 will give you the distance between these two parallel axes, that is global x and local xx axis. It will be around 15.62. So there are four such sections, so into 4 we will be getting IS 53763.47 centimeter to the power of 4. So both global IXX and global IYY will be same, because everything is symmetrical over here. You can substitute that value here. You have to substitute the area of all the angle sections combined. So R minimum will be getting 16.26 centimeter. So substitute in this slenderness ratio formula, slenderness ratio lambda will be getting 24.6. So the design compressive strength, A, you have to substitute the overall area of all four angle sections combined. So once again, this also falls under compound or built up member, so it will be coming under buckling class C. So I had referred table 9C. So from table 9C, for slenderness ratio of 24.6 and for yield stress of 250, after interpolation you will be getting FCD as 218.02. So the strength of this particular column is 4429.29, but the load acting, the factored load is 3750. So design is safe. So once again, connection is not required because he has not asked it. So moving on to the last problem. Design a built-up column using a pair of I sections placed at a suitable spacing to support the working load of 1600 kN. The height of the column is 7 meter and the end conditions are both the ends rotation as well as translation are restrained. That means both the ends are fixed. So this is how your column will be. Pair of I section with some adequate distance, I'll be taking it as D. So this will be the centroid for both the sections combined. Centroid X axis, centroid Y axis for two I sections combined. And this will be the location of centroid for I section. So local X and global X will be coinciding with the global X axis. So this will be the local YY axis. So if you are not sure where the center out of this I section is, you can refer steel table, the figure given in steel table. So once again, the area required for once again, this properties is not readily available. you have to divide the total area by 2. So for one I section it will be this much. So for referring the tables of one I section, we'll be choosing IS I will be 450. So the provided area will be 166.28. The required was 160 centimeter square. Provided is 166.28. So both the ends are fixed. That means from table 11, this will be the formula to get effective length. So effective length will be 4.55. Once again, R minimum should be obtained manually because there is no properties of two I sections, a pair of I sections placed at adequate distance from your steel table. Once again, parallaxis theorem. If you are calculating IXX, this distance will be zero. There are two such sections, so into two IXX. IYY, once again, from the distance between these two is the half of the flange width plus dy. Simple. So that is what he has been substituted here into 2. So you have to calculate d here, so we will be equating IXX and IYY. So the IXX which you get here, we will be assuming that IYY is also same. So there is no question of I minimum, so we will be substituting this value directly. And here the area of two I sections combined. So R minimum will be 18.19. Lambda, once again same formula, you will be getting 25. So I will perform the check. Once again, this falls under buckling class C as it is a built up member. So from table 9C, I have to get FCD. So from table 9C, for stress ratio of 25 and for yield stress of 250, you will be getting FCD after interpolation 217.5. So the strength of this column is 3616. The load acting is 2400. So the design is safe. Thank you. This is relating to design of compression members.